My name is Evgeny Apov. I am a co-founder and CEO of Epiphany. Epiphany is an API management vendor. We are based in Washington, D.C. And today I want to talk about my view and our view on the API economy, what it means for companies, for people, and about several APIs that I think everybody should know about when you're thinking about building new business. So as you know, there are many ways how companies leverage APIs. And one of the ways, we call it building a partner ecosystem or build a platform. And I'll give an example using Salesforce. That's one of the favorite example, not only for me, but it seems like for many other presenters. So Salesforce, and we are a Salesforce customer, and I know it from my experience how it works for us. So when we first time bought Salesforce license, it was for sales team. Few licenses for sales team. Then we discovered nice tools that you can use to upload data into Salesforce. And next thing you see, we need more licenses for IT team. Then we discovered marketing tools. Very convenient to be to have all these tools as as one on one platform, and more licenses for marketing team. And then it's keep growing. You have different tools as part of this Salesforce partner ecosystem. Your organization, many teams of organization become users of Salesforce, and it's win-win-win. Organizations are leveraging value that Salesforce provide with the partner ecosystem. So Salesforce is happy because they are getting more and more usage and more licenses. And a lot of partners benefit the distribution channels that channels that they get being a part of Salesforce platform. So it's a we work with startups, and I always teach startups that they should think about an API and open their platform for partners, because when you start up, you have a limited resources, you have limited time, and you want to, and you really want to leverage partners, and you want to leverage partners to extend your system, to bring more value for your customers, and to distribute your product to as many customers as you can. That's very powerful powerful view or powerful way of using APIs. Let's look at another example. A lot of retail, travel industries, they are leveraging affiliate programs. Let's look at Best Buy. So when Best Buy started, they started with a website. I mean, not like stores, but when they went to online. And they got some website users. Users pays, buy some stuff from Best Buy. Then they decided, okay, let's open up our API for developers. Let's leverage developer ecosystem and let's developer to build new applications. So developers build mobile apps. They got some mobile users. They buy some stuff from Best Buy, and Best Buy gives some money to developers. Developers have money to build more applications and more users, more money flows different ways. So that's, again, win, win, win. Everybody wins in this setup. Let's look at another well-known use case of using APIs. We call it a developer ecosystem. And let's look at New York Times. New York Times, one of the revenue stream for New York Times and other publishing companies, it's ads revenue, so they're serving ads. And initially they have web users, they give some eyeballs, and New York Times get some revenue from advertising. Then they realize that they're losing audience, because now we all like to use mobile devices. We don't want to go to websites. So they decided to open APIs for developers and let developers to build mobile apps. Hopefully developers build good app, and we are ready to pay for those apps. So developers get some money from users. Users are using these mobile applications and to search for the content, and go, as they go to website, they give some, they drive some eyeballs to New York Times. New York Times got some money, and again, it's more applications, more eyeballs, more revenue for New York Times. Again, it's win-win-win. And this is my favorite example of how companies are leveraging APIs. When I look at this this picture, it makes me excited, because it's just few samples of companies that are leveraging other companies to build their business and to cut time to market, maintenance expenses, development expenses. It's a lot of triangles that you can see, like Twilio use Zendesk, and Zendesk use Twilio. I don't know if they pay each other. I mean, is there some special arrangement? But it's leveraging businesses, and I cannot imagine this picture back in the enterprise days. And let's see why. Let's take like old days enterprise, like typical enterprise project. So how it starts? It starts with virtualization layer. So you need to build infrastructure to build your the project. Then you need to add some database layer. So it drives budgets up. It drives a number of team members you need to hire to maintain, support all this infrastructure, and it drives time project, duration of the project up. Then perhaps you need some HR system and some ETL tools, so you add those tools into your infrastructure, and it drives those numbers up, and it keep going. So you adding more and more tools, products into your infrastructure. And can you imagine if one of those companies in those days would like to leverage some other products or tools, it makes customers to basically buy all these complementary products, support them, maintain them, hire some SIs to integrate all this project together. So it takes years and hundreds, millions of dollars to to deploy and leverage products. So good thing that in our API days we can leverage businesses easily. So you start with backend as services. You build your logic. You can do it now in days, weeks. You add some cool functionality using telephony companies like Twilio and QuickFuse to add some SMS, voice features. You can easily leverage email and communication tools to add communication functionality in your product. Then maybe some cool technology, innovative technologies that allows you to like text recognition, image recognition, and some semantic analysis. That's cool products that you can use to build new business and be innovative fast and effectively. Then orchestration layers to orchestrate all those APIs. Billing to make some money, because we are talking about business. And don't forget about API management tools to be part of this ecosystem, because you want to be one of those block. You want to be part of this ecosystem, growing ecosystem. And for that you need API, you need a developer portal. So that's very important. So that's, I don't want to read all those names. You can find them on our blog, like blog on our website, or I will make this presentation available for download, so you can take advantage of some names that we put together in different construction blocks. So that's my presentation. If you have any question.
And what are you doing? Can you describe some use cases?
Yeah, for instance, Washington Post, it's one of our customers, and they basically, they drive traffic to their website using APIs and leveraging developers. So that's this developer ecosystem example. We have customers that are startups, and they have some interesting logic that they expose on API, and they part of this ecosystem. So they one of those blocks, and so yeah, we do API management. So we help companies to be one of those construction blocks for other businesses.
Any more questions? Please join me. I'm good. Continue.
Huh?
Yeah, good.
I'm done.
You're done. Okay. All right, then I think you deserve a huge round of applause. Thank you so much.
Thank you.